Welcome back. It is one of the most successful film franchises of all time, and now there is a new chapter in the Ice Age story.
This time Manny and the gang find themselves cast adrift into the ocean after a squirrel's pursuit of an acorn goes very badly wrong.
It's always the acorn, isn't it? All the favourite characters are back, but there are also some new stars in the mix, including Jennifer Lopez. We'll be talking to the film's directors in a second. Morning to you both again. Mm-hmm. First, have a little look at it.
We made it through storms and tidal waves and a vicious assortment of seafood. What more can they hit us with?
Ow!
I want to get up. I'll get up right now. I don't want to get dead, Nettie. I'm trying to sleep.
Granny, you're alive!
And can we say how thrilled we are to see you?
You want to get me out of here? Woo! Hey! Come on! Pretend I'm a dessert. That should motivate you.
You slept through that storm.
Oh.
I slept through the comet that killed the unicorns. This is my first bath in decades.
Quick, somebody do something.
I got you, Granny.
Get off of me.
Ow.
Oh, Granny.
What are you peeping toms all looking at? Lady can't take a bath in peace? Eyeballing me like a rump roast.
What's the life expectancy for a female sloth?
Oh, she'll outlive us all, you know that, right? Yeah, the spiteful ones live the longest.
Oh, Mike Thurmeier and Steve Martino, the co-directors of Ice Age 4, are here with us now. Morning, both. Thanks very much for joining
us.
Have you been on board the project right from the beginning, both of you?
Oh, yeah. 2009.
So you must feel pretty fond, like the people who watch this, of those characters.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, yeah, they're like part of our family. We've kind of grown up with them as a studio. As we've seen them go from story to story, it's been wonderful.
Yeah, I've been on every Ice Age since the first one in 2002. Yeah.
Can you explain, for those that don't know, that includes me, the I understand the role of a director in a conventional movie, which is you're stood behind the camera, they're shooting, you're advising the actors, you're talking about it. When you're co-directors, as you are, of an animated film, what are you actually, day to day, what are you doing?
Well, we've got a crew of over 300 animators, story artists, people who bring every element to this film, the color, the lighting, everything that you see in that in the film has to be created, needs to be designed, colors need to be determined, what the materials will be like.
So we talk to artists basically all day. Like you spend the whole day and you talk a movie into existence. You describe to artists your vision and these brilliant people.
So you're sat at a kind of Uber computer somewhere, and are they sending what they think you want see to you? How does it work?
That would be kind of cool. We go around the studio, we go to different departments, and we have screening rooms and, you know, a nice theater, and they show us stuff in rooms like that.
Yeah.
Okay. And we also, when we're working with the actors, I mean, Steve and I will play against, say, Jennifer Lopez when we're at a recording studio. So in one case, I was playing Diego and she was playing Shira. Which is a little bit disconcerting because when you're reading off the script and you look up and Jennifer Lopez is looking right at you, acting intensely, it's like, well,
your love interest.
Yeah, playing a love interest. It was
well,
pretty
I think
cool.
We can hear it. It's one of those sequences now. So let's have a look.
Yeah. Okay. Hey, God, Flynn, anyone there?
Here, grab hold.
No, go away. I'd rather drown.
Whatever the lady wants.
I said I didn't need your help.
You're welcome. So, care to join our scurvy crew?
Two sloths, a mammoth, and a saber? You guys are like the start of a bad joke.
And we saved you. That makes you the punchline, kitty.
Don't call me kitty.
Okay, I won't. Kitty.
If they kiss, I'm gonna puke.
lots of new characters as well, including Granny, who's a bit of a star, isn't she?
Yes. It's an incredible cast. We've got so many new performers, a very international cast, because we've got a band of pirates that intersect our crew, and they're from all over the world. Nick Frost, you know, from here in the UK. Jennifer Lopez, who is a great foil for Diego. She is equally smart, tough, funny, as you see in that clip.
And Peter Dinklage from Game of Thrones.
Hey, you were talking about how the voiceover thing works, those characters. So are you looking at the animated pictures? Whilst the artists are doing the voiceovers, are they seeing a finished product in terms of the... No, nothing at all.
Look at his eyes.
I think this is the biggest challenge we have as directors. When we sit in the recording booth with the actors, we need to paint a picture of what that scene will be. Mike and I know what we envision that action to be. And as we sit and work and create an environment for them to create, it's a matter of having them understand through sketches, drawings. We show, you know, renderings of what the action might look like. And we try to give them an imagination for what the scene is.
They put a lot of trust in us because they're kind of like, okay, I guess I get what you're talking about. And we do our best to really put them in the scene and help them.
So what's it like when they see the movie?
Hopefully it's fantastic and they're very happy. But, you know, we show them clips along the way. As we're developing the movie, we record with them maybe 6-7 times. And each step, we bring a little bit more. So that first recording session, we've got nothing but little sketches and simple drawings. And then as we get further into the process, we can show them actual footage.
And I might be really stupid here, but presumably none of this is actually on paper anymore. Is it all on computers, or how does it work?
The initial sketches, a lot of them are still done on paper. I mean, Steve would always bring a sketchbook. Yeah. He filled many sketchbooks of drawings as we talk to the artists or the actors. But everything created on screen now is, in a computer.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
There might be some people of a certain age. You think that the 3D element of a film like this is possibly superfluous. That if you, even in animated films, if you have a wonderful story and you've got engaging characters, then maybe you don't need the other stuff. Uh-huh, and I know that's where we are now, and that's the industry does that because you can. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Do you think it's necessary now? Well, does it need to be 3D? Do you think?
I would say, does it need to be 3D? No, but you could say a film doesn't need to be in color either.
Well, indeed, we've just had a film that was
that color. Yeah, but it adds color, can add 3D, adds to it. And compared to Ice Age 3, when we were just sort of stepping into 3D for the first time and really kind of learning it, we had a much more active approach. Steve and I would work with our 3D department very closely, and they would show us stuff along the way, and we would say, you know, this is what we want, and so we were able to get much more out of it, I think, on this film. So I feel really good about the 3D.
We're not in 3D at the moment, but let's have a look. Not yet.
Someday, maybe.
Thank goodness. Let's have a look at another clip of the film when the Ice Age gang find themselves in trouble.
Just keep your eye on the horizon!
I can't find the horizon!
Hold me!
If I don't make it, find me a wife and tell her I love her!
We made it! Come on, Ocean! Is that the best you can do? Am I right, buddy?
I have to say, having seen the film, my favorite sequences, I'm probably slightly out of kilter, are still the ones with the squirrel.
Oh, yeah.
The squirrel with the acorn.
Uh-huh. Absolutely.
That are in some ways quite simple, aren't they?
Sure.
Well, I think the Scrat is pure animation. It's pantomime. It doesn't require lines or jokes. Yes. Mm. It's pure physical humor. And I think it's the kind of entertainment that plays to all ages and plays around the world because it's right there in the animated acting.
He's kind of Chaplin-esque. You don't need the
and he has a key role in this film. I won't say any more, though.
Lovely to see you here. Thank you both very much for coming.
Thank you.
Our pleasure.
Ice Age 4 Continental Drift is out on July the 13th. If you're quick, though, there are previews in cinemas from this weekend.